Today we will learn to upload files, directly from your computer, to your Google Colab notebook. And then, create charts from that data, using PyPlot. We have a CSV file, containing data of salaries. By employees, gender, and department. First of all, we will upload this data. Then we will create some charts, using this data. We will analyze salaries by employees, gender, and department. And we will display that information, in charts. First, we will go to our Google Drive folder. Then, we will create a new Google Colab notebook. And wait for it to load. In the Google Colab notebook, first we will load all the libraries we need. We will import the pandas library, which we will use to read the uploaded CSV file. We will access the library, using pd in our entire code. Then we will import the PyPlot library, which will be used to create charts and visualizations. PyPlot library is part of the matplot library. We will access the PyPlot library using plt. To upload files from our local drive, we will need the files library from Google Colab. Now we have all the necessary libraries. We can use the files.upload command to upload files from our local drive into the Google Colab notebook. To upload the file, we must run the code. After a few seconds, this will create an upload button, which will display the file open dialog box. Here, select the file you want to upload, and press open. Now, the Google Colab will start uploading the file. Wait for the process to complete. Once the file is uploaded 100%, you can use the file in your Python code. Now we will add another code block. The purpose of adding another code block is to keep the next code separate from the previous one. This is not entirely necessary. But by doing so, you won't have to run the entire code every time you make a small change somewhere. You can run codes in blocks. The file we uploaded will remain available, since that code has been run already. Running that code, and uploading that file again and again, won't make any difference, other than increasing labor and wasting time. Now we will use the pandas.readcsv command, to read the CSV file, that we have already uploaded. Here we will enter the name of the CSV file. The name of the CSV file is the same as the name of the file we uploaded previously. If you enter the name of another file, which was not uploaded, the code will give you an error. Also remember, the file name is case sensitive. If you enter a letter in wrong case, it will also cause an error. Let's use the pandas.head command to load the headers and first few rows of the data frame. Print command will display the data on screen. File has been correctly loaded, and now we can use this data to create some charts. We will again create a new code block. Here, we will define the figure and axis of our chart using the pyplot.subplots command. A pyplot figure refers to the entire window or page that contains all the elements of a plot. It's the top-level container that holds everything you want to display in a single plot, such as lines, markers, labels, titles, axes, and more. Now, we will define the chart type, which is a horizontal bar chart. Here we will enter the columns from our data frame, which will be used in the bar chart. We want to create a bar chart, showing salaries by employees. Therefore, we entered both columns. We will use the set title command to define a title for our chart. Enter the title of your chart here. Set X label is used to enter the title for X axis, which in our case is employees. Set Y label is used to set title for the Y axis, which will be salaries. To display the legend, use the legend command. Finally, we will use the show command to finalize and display the chart. Let's run the code and see the result. Here is the bar chart that we created. To create another chart, we will just copy the existing code and paste it in another code block. To display salaries by departments, we will just change the employee to department in both places. Now we will run the code to see the chart we just created. However, this chart is not accurate because each department contains various employees, and we did not guide the PyPlot on which salary to display. We will make some changes in our code and display total salaries by each department. We will create another data frame where we will group the data by departments. We will use the pandas.group by command to do so. Inside the group by, we will enter the column name by which we want to group the data, which is department. And the grouped data will be displayed as total, as defined by the sum here. We will modify the data frame by resetting the index using the reset index command. The first column, which is department, is used as index, therefore it cannot be used in a chart. Resetting the index will make it a normal column. We will now take both columns from this data frame instead of the original one, by changing S into D. Let's see what happened. And as you can see, each department is now displaying total salary of its employees. To display salaries by gender, we will copy the existing code and paste it into a new code block. We will change the name of data frame to G and enter gender in group by. We will replace department with gender and the name of data frame D with G. Let's run the code and see the result. The chart is perfect, however, for this type of data, a pie chart is more appropriate instead of a bar chart. To display this data on a pie chart, first we will remove gender column from axis and place it in legend. Then we will change the type of chart to pie. Now, we can run the code. Perfect! Our pie chart is ready, and it explains the data better and appeals to the eyes more as well. This concludes our today's session. Thanks for watching. We hope you liked our tutorial. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials and updates.